Good day, fellow investors. Now, I've made a lot of videos and almost under each video I get, what do you think about this stock, what do you think about this stock, and I have put all those stocks on a list, and I finally made a video where I analyzed the first 15 stocks on the list. So, subscribers, here I'll shortly analyze what I think about the stocks you have asked about here on the channel. Now, before we start, I'm a very, very picky stock picker. That means that I'm happy if I buy 1, 2, 3 stocks during the whole year. So I'm really, really careful what I buy. I have made, therefore, a categorization. So I see a bad stock destroying value. Okay stock, market perform 4 to 6% in the long term. Good stock from 8 to 13% in the long term. Great stock, and that's what I'm looking at, and you can see why it is so difficult to find. So I want potential 50% in a year, multi-bagger in a few years, with low risk, with a margin of safety. So don't get mad if I say, okay, this is a good stock, this is a okay stock, and there will be a few great stocks, I can guarantee you that. But that's just me, so use me as a way to check what you're doing. My risk-reward preferences are really extreme. This is because I spend 15 hours a day looking at stocks, doing research, analyzing. So somebody is happy with 10% a year, 13, 15% a year, and that's very good. And there are actually, as you will see, stocks that will offer that. So don't get mad if I say it's not a great stock. So let's start immediately. The first company I have on my list was Tractor Supply. Current valuation 16.3. Growth 8% per year, however, it has a low book value, so that's a deterrent for me. Growing debt levels, it performed very well in the recession, so it has a margin of safety. Now they are expanded into oil markets, which can be very costly in the future, over expansion, and their same store sales are a little bit down. To conclude, it's a choppy outlook for a relatively high PE. So I would say it's between okay and a good stock. You can expect 6% or 7%, 8% in the long term from Tractor Supply. It's a good company to be invested in, but think realistically. And the stock price is extremely low now, so a good company. Fresh Del Monte Produce, it's in the positive part of its cycle. It has high competition. 30% of the company was bought back, which means they invested a lot by buying shares, which is good when you do it when the price was below book value, as it was a year or two ago. I wrote a Seeking Alpha article where my target was 65 over the next 5 years with a price earnings ratio of 17. The price was then 30, now the price is 50 something. So it was much better. It was a much better investment when it was 30. I would say it's an okay company at these levels. You can expect it to go to 65. From a fundamental perspective, from a market perspective, is if there is euphoria, it can go to crazy levels. TEP, the price earnings ratio here is low due to one-off event. It will be much higher, and so you can see the forward price earnings ratio is 15.5. So that's not such a cheap company. I expect my returns to come from earnings. Now, if you take a price earnings ratio of 15.5 for a brewing company, it's very low, but nevertheless, it's all about sentiment. 15.5 means a return about 6-7%. There is some margin of safety in the book value. So to conclude, between okay and good in the long term. All right, this is a small cap, micro cap. Zinc One Resources, expect further dilution. They're looking at the mine that was abandoned in the past. Now they want to start mining again, which means they need a higher zinc price. That means that there is no margin of safety if zinc prices go lower. I'm a margin of safety value investor. I like to invest in companies that have mining costs into the first quartile, not higher. This is really a bet on higher zinc prices. Yes, zinc will go into a supply gap. There is a potential of higher prices, but I don't know whether that will happen this year, next year, or in the next 3 to 5 years. Therefore, I need a margin of safety. They need still a lot of permissions. What to do is to follow drill results, estimate the preliminary economic assessment before it's made, if you can do that. and then you can make an investment there. So you have to really know what's going on and follow the company. There is potential, but that potential needs to be followed and analyzed. On the personal side, I prefer less risk. Northern Dynasty Minerals. Oh, this is a complicated one. Pebble mine in Australia, full of regulatory issues, can end up either way. Extremely expensive to build, and again, not in the first quarter of cost, so really betting on higher metal prices. Anglo-American walked away from the project, so huge risk, and I prefer less risk. Again, if you are a lawyer, if you know what the government will do, will they give permissions, then you might lower your risk and increase your returns. If not, then it's just betting, not for me. Taseko Mines had a debt problem which is refinanced to 2022. They have new Prosperity project, Florence project, again with regulatory risk. And the projects are all low grade, so high expenses. They want to use a new system on the Florence project that will lower costs but is very detrimental for the environment. Nevertheless, it's cash flow positive, but they need higher copper prices. So again, no margin of safety for me. However, high potential if copper prices jump. A lot of permitting needed, but net present value is high compared to market capitalization. Therefore, it's interesting to follow, but I don't like the low grades. Prefer high grades. Nevertheless, I will follow the company. Now, Orkla ASA, Norway. It's a company that sells food, Norway, Baltics. Very interesting, very stable, as people will buy food, whatever happens. However, the current valuation is a bit high, which implies a return of 5%. Price to book is a little bit high. Price to cash flow is again 5%, and they are spending 60% of it for the dividend yield. This is a good company, high price earnings ratio for slower growth, market performance is expected. And the risk is not coming from the company itself, but from the environment. Higher interest rates might hit the stock badly. So, target annual EBIT growth is 6 to 9% for a price earnings ratio of 20. I would say this is a good company. Now, Deutsche Rohstoff, oil and gas and rare earths. Such companies are really, really bets. If you're exposed to those companies, you can really make a killing if they find something, if they have additional value to it. Therefore, there are also risks if they don't find something. So it has to be compared to other drillers in the US shale industry. What are their costs? The money they make, they will probably reinvest in future projects, all short-term projects, so it's difficult to know what's going on. It's probably good investment at these oil prices, as I have checked their net present values, so the discount is there. However, I don't know what will be the catalyst that will push it much higher from the market. So it can be a value trap, but again, if you know the company, it can be a good company. Pets at Home, this is an interesting one. Stable company, small company, low debt, good stock. What has to be analyzed is the British pound effect, as they buy in probably from around the world and sell now in England, so their margins will probably get squeezed and price earnings ratio higher. Correct me if I am wrong. However, the premium here is also for the smallness, small cap, interesting dividend yield. So if someone wants to dig into it and check what will happen with the pound, then he might have a very interesting investment to park your money and enjoy significant growth and a good dividend yield. Silvercorp, take a look at this company for a silver play. It's mining in China, which is very interesting, and usually investors don't like when something is going on in China, especially when the company is traded in Canada and so. Was much cheaper 2 years ago, but there might still be value, and it's very interesting play for silver. So this company goes onto my future research list if I ever want to get exposed to silver. Tyson Foods, it's a cyclical company depending on food prices and feed prices. And feed prices have started to going up, thus we will see lower margin. Price earnings ratio to be at the peak of the cycle is a bit high, so we can expect higher price earnings ratio when the cycle reverts. SORL, Chinese car parts company, a little bit too late. The huge surge already happened. Higher debt, falling book value, no dividend and negative cash flows despite the growth and high earnings. The management has been doing something which they buy and do a lot of intercompany transactions, so it has to be checked out. And then again, 8 million on the balance sheet. Can be used for growth, but check before you invest. Alio Gold issued warrants and stocks at current price. Warrants and stocks dilutes current owners by 30%. I don't like dilution, but it could be interesting. However, the Ana Paula project is not de-risked yet. There is still permitting, drilling, and so on. So it's, let's say, fairly priced for the risk at this stage. Again, it's interesting to make an analysis and see what comes out. All these miners, you really need to dig into all the data and then put it in the model and see what comes out of it. There, that is the only way to analyze miners, and that takes a few days for me to do on a stock. Caledonia mining, again, looks good, look into it. And we have the final one, a mortgage REIT, NLY, Annaly Capital Management. Mortgage in a credit economy, this could blow up in your face. So I know the price earnings ratio is low, dividend yield is extremely high, but that's because there is a high risk. So I will dig into some miners probably to create a model and then get a real present value in comparison to what can happen and the risks. So you can expect somewhere in the future a video, a detailed analysis of those miners, because I like to keep a database with exactly, okay, this is the value, what happened, and then I can jump in if I have the capital available. For the rest, I see a lot of good companies that will bring good returns, 5, 10, 15% in the next few years, which is very good. I'm an investor that really spends a lot of time on researching, and I expect much higher returns, so don't get mad on me. I also have made an analysis of just the first 15 stocks. The list goes on, so you can expect sometime in the future another video on the next stocks. If you have a company that you think that might surge 50, 100%, that has a margin of safety, that has good fundamentals, so everything to make it a great stock, please share it with us in the comments below, and I'm happy to make an analysis and even perhaps a video on the stock. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.